to ICT 7. Today, we will tackle Week 6, the presentation software. Under presentation software, we have rules in creating presentations, master slide, animation, and the animation pane. First, rules in creating presentations. One idea in one slide. This allows the audience to focus on a concept on each slide, thus make it easier for them to comprehend and remember. Follow their five rules. The 5-5-5 rule is a simple guide to keep things short. Observe 5 words per line, no more than 5 lines per slide, and of having 5 slides in a row with lots of text. This rule helps keep your audience engaged and paying attention. Avoiding slide overload. Limit your elements to 6 or fewer on each slide. This keeps things focused. Also, use short text, add some space, and include images or graphics smartly. Fourth, mastering slide design. A clear and meaningful heading is a must. It helps your audience understand what is coming up. Make sure your heading is a short and clear summary of your entire presentation. Effective slide design. Use colors that stand out. Keep backgrounds simple and use big fonts. As much as possible, do not use italics, underlining, or all caps because they might take away the audience's focus from your main message. Appropriate animation. Avoid using too many animations. Research shows that an audience does not like too many movements. Small, simple animations can help highlight key points and make your audience remember things better. Using too many might distract the audience and make your presentations less effective. Utilize visual presentations. Use images and graphs to add interest and engagement to your presentation, but make sure to observe balance. Avoid complex graphics that may distract your audience. When you decide to use a graph or chart, make sure to explain what it shows so everyone understands the information you are sharing. Next, the master slide. Master slide is designed to achieve consistency and professional-looking presentation. In PowerPoint presentation, you could use Slide Master View to modify all slides and the slide layouts of your presentation. Here are some of the most common uses of the Slide Master View. First, modify backgrounds. It customizes the backgrounds for all of your slides at the same time. Rearrange placeholders. If you accidentally rearrange the placeholders on each slide, you can save time by rearranging them using the Slide Master View. Customize text formatting. You could also use the Slide Master View to change the text color on all slides at once. Create unique slide layouts. You could use Slide Master View to create your own unique layouts. Customizing slide layouts. Click the View tab from the ribbon in the Master Views group. Click Slide Master View. In customizing slide layout, locate and select the desired layout in the left navigation pane. In some layouts, the background graphics may be hidden. add, move, or delete any objects as desired. If you want to change the arrangements of the placeholders, you can move, resize, or delete any of them. When you're finished, click the Close Master View command on the Slide Master tab. All slides using the layout will be updated. Next, create new slide layouts. First, click the View tab from the ribbon. In the Master Views group, click Slide Master View. Click the Insert Layout command, the new slide layout will appear. The layout will include title and footer placeholder. By default, click the title and footer boxes in the master layout group to toggle these placeholders on and off. You can now add background graphics, shapes, and pictures to the slide layout. You can also move, adjust, and delete the existing placeholder. To add new placeholder, click the down arrow of the Insert Placeholder command, then select the desired placeholder type. Click and drag to draw the placeholder on the slide. The motion path. Animations in Microsoft PowerPoint come in a variety of forms. Effects can be applied to shapes, pictures, and text. For guided practice, here's the step. Open the practice presentation file, click an object that you want to animate. On the Animations tab from the ribbon, click Add Animations. Scroll down to Motion Paths and pick one from the list. If you would like to draw the path, choose Custom Path from the list. Draw the path in the slide to stop drawing a custom path and press Escape. If you do not like any of the motion paths in the list, click More Motion Paths. Click an animation to see a preview of how the object will move on your slide. Select the motion path you want, then click OK. So here's the example. These are the motion paths, the custom paths, and the more motion paths. We have also the animations for entrance, emphasis, and also for exit. You could also click the more entrance effect for more entrance options, the more emphasis effects, and also the more exit effects. You should see the movement of the object in your slide and try to change the direction, sequence, origin, and path. Click Effect Options from the Animations tab and choose from given list. You should see the effect on the object you have selected. In case you want to remove an animation on the slide, click the motion path dotted line with arrow and then press Delete. Save the changes you have made to your practice presentation. Lastly, the animation pane. Essential part of the animation tab, this command enables you to control and view every effect on the active slide. The animation pane allows you to easily edit and rearrange effects, which is very helpful if you have multiple effects. It also allows you to have an easy and quick preview of the animation's effects that you have selected. The effect start option and timing can also be set using the animation pane.
So here's the example on how to use animations or the animation pane using the PowerPoint presentation. If you watch my previous video, I think nagbigay ako ng mga example ng mga games na pwede natin magamit sa classroom and in-apply ko doon yung mga animations, the animation pane for that example. So today, eto yung example ko na ginamit sa aking lessons to. For pretest, for Household and Services 9, in-apply ko yung animation pane. So madali lang naman siya, kailangan nyo lang makinig, manood, then sundan kung paano yung tamang paggawa or paggamit ng animation pane. So let us start, watch, and learn. So here's the example. Let us play the example. So again, types of floor that is durable, versatile, and not easily pierced. Is it hard floor, soft floor, or vinyl? Let us click the soft loop. It is wrong. So it corresponds to Ekis. So anong narinig natin, meron siyang additional effects and sounds. So vinyl is also a wrong. But when I click the correct answer, meron siyang sound. And then lalabas siya automatic yung ating check na it corresponds to correct answer. Now, paano ba natin i-apply yon? So eto lang kasimple. So kinapi ko muna yung slide na yon, dinuplicate ko siya. So first step, punta tayo sa animation. Make sure all the elements, pictures na gusto mong lagyan ng effects or animations, just put an animations. So here, so the first natin, the first question, let us use float in animations. The next, the hard floor, float in na lang para hindi siya masakit sa mata. Float in, simple lang yung ating games. And then, the check one, lalagyan natin siya ng zoom. Ngayon, bahala kung ano yung gusto nyong animations na gusto nyong lagyan. Make sure lahat ng elements na gusto nyong gamitin is lalagyan natin siya ng animations. Kasi dito tayo magbe-base sa animation pane. So, ngayon, punta tayo sa animation pane. But before that, i-check muna natin kung anong text box ba yung ating mga lalagyan ng animation pane. First, the rectangle 10, the hard floor, rectangle 14, 18, and then yung check natin is picture 22, picture 19 is 6, and the picture 21 is 7. Now, kailangan, kabisador, alam nyo kung ano yung picture na i-click nyo, and then kung anong rectangle na ba siya. Ayan. So, let us check the rectangle 10, the picture 2, or animation to the hard floor and rectangle 10, ang kanyang name. So, i-click natin itong trigger. On click off, ibig sabihin, kapag click yung 2, lalabas yung check. So, dito tayo sa check. Kasi siya yung dapat na lalabas kapag click natin yung question or yung choices. Kapag click natin tong hard floor na choices, dapat lalabas na check kasi siya yung tama. Now, i-click natin yung picture 22, and then, i-click natin yung trigger. So, ang sabi ni trigger, on click off. On click off, what picture? The rectangle 10. Ayan. So, nakita natin, meron siyang parang kidlat na sign. So, ibig sabihin, na-triggered na natin si check sa ating rectangle 10 na tamang sagot. Next, yung wrong answer natin na to, is iti-trigger natin siya sa rectangle 14. On click off, rectangle 14. Next. So, ganun lang din yung gagawin natin sa iba pang. Gusto natin i-trigger rectangle 18. Now, kung gusto mong bigyan ng sounds, dito tayo sa animation pane. So, magpo-focus lang kayo dito sa may animation pane. Ayan, nalipat na tayo. Dito lang tayo sa may animation pane. Magpo-focus. So, ito. Lalagyan natin siya ng sounds. Ayan, effects, options. Okay, pwedeng timing, on-click, delay. Then, pwede natin siya lagyan ng sounds. So, applause yung ating sounds. Takasan natin yung kanyang volume. Then, click OK. Then, kapag wrong naman, lalagyan natin siya ng sounds also. Na bump. And then, lalakasan natin siya ng bonggang-bongga. Then, click OK. Next, this one. We will put effects. Bam. Super lakasan natin siya. Okay. Now, let us test. To try na natin siya. Natin kung tama ba. Okay, the question is, the type of floor that is durable, versatile, and not easily pierced. Hard floor, soft floor, vinyl. May answer is soft floor. Wrong. May answer is vinyl. Wrong also. Answer is floor, so, diba? Para yung mga bata kapag ganito yung mga nakikita or sila yung mismong magpipili ng mga answer nila parang na nagagandahan or lumalakas yung kanilang loob kapag narinig nila ay tama siya and then mali. So that's the simple demonstration or tutorial on how to use the animations and also the animation pane. I hope na natutunan at nakasunod tayo. That's all. Thank you.
That's the end of our lesson for today. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and share, subscribe, and hit the bell button.